Hey there everyone, and welcome back to my channel. My name is Eric Merced, and for today's video, I decided to do something a little different. Something I haven't done in quite a while. So I sketched a quick silly cartoon character head, and I thought I'd ink it on video today for you all while providing some of my thoughts. I did a video a while back on my traditional inking tools, and in that video I went through most of the inking tools I use when working traditionally. I'll leave a link to the video in this video's description section for you to see if you haven't yet. But the reason I bring it up is because in that video I mentioned the two pens I'm using today for inking this character. The first one, which is my favorite traditional inking tool, is the Pentel Pocket Brush Pen. I mainly use this brush pen, which is refillable by the way, to do my line work, which is exactly what I'm doing here now by outlining the character. For those of you who are also curious, this is one of the first videos I recorded using my new overhead video setup rig. It's a super simple setup, and if there's enough interest, I'll do a video on it. Just leave your comment in the comment section on whether that's a video you'd like to see in the future. As most of you know, these days I rarely ink traditionally, preferring instead to ink digitally in Procreate or, at times, Clip Studio Paint. While I enjoy inking digitally, there are times I do enjoy busting out the old traditional tools and getting my hands dirty with ink like the good old days. It's also good practice to work without the parachute that is undo and redo and layers. But having inked both traditionally and digitally, I can honestly say, both methods are hard. And in both, you have to learn control of your inking hand and tool. Especially, and maybe even more so, in digital. Because no matter which way you cut it, that's basically inking on glass, which is slippery as hell if you don't have some kind of screen protector that offers some sort of texture, versus inking on paper, which naturally offers resistance. Either way, I enjoy both methods of inking. I've been asked in the past why I still ink my work, why I haven't adopted a new look like lineless work, which I've actually tried in the past. The simple answer is that I just really enjoy inking. By default, I'm a comic book cartoonist. That's where my work is rooted in. So it's what I naturally go towards. I can try different styles, and I have in the past, but the style I enjoy the most is when I ink my own work. I feel the work just comes alive in the inking stage. Okay, so here I've switched from the Pentel Pocket Brush Pen to another Pentel brush pen. This is a Pentel Color brush pen. These come in colors, but also in black, and I mainly use this brush pen to do heavy blacks and backgrounds. You can easily use this brush pen to do an entire drawing with. I know some of my favorite artists who use these brush pens to ink their entire work, from line art to backgrounds to filling in spot blacks. I need to try this one day. I know it can be easily done with just this pen because, unlike the Pentel Pocket brush pen, I find that these pens have a greater variety of line widths you can get out of them. Another thing I like about this brush pen is that it holds a lot of ink, more ink actually than the Pentel Pocket brush pen. And I find that you can get dry brush effects with this pen much easier than you can with the Pentel Pocket brush pen. With the Pentel Pocket brush pen, I tend to be careful with it because I don't want to mess up the brush tip. But with this pen, I feel a little bit freer to experiment with and get those nice dry brush effects. Well, I hope you've enjoyed this video. I really want to make more videos like this. If you'd like to see more videos like this too, go ahead and let me know in the comments section. Until then, thank you all for watching. Thank you all for supporting the channel. I'll see you all in the next video. Until then, peace and God bless you all.